can serve as the hub of our journeys. Mind the guards on watch, Master. They'll not suffer any untoward behavior like you. The Scrivener at the Black Cat here can duplicate objects in your possession.
Here for business? Then you've heard not the news. Madeline's in some trouble of late. She abandoned a shop and fled under cover at night.
Remember the item I asked you to find? Well, now, let us talk of business. You'd be a fool. Pray, call it.
Yes, Kang's wife was talk of Madeline. Rumor has it she was dealing in illicit goods. Some authority uncovered her game and she was forced to shutter her shop. I hear she fled, too, before the guards had a chance to arrest her. Just what was she up to? I'd like to know.
Madeline's shop? Sure, everyone knows of it. She bought the place when the first owner fled the dragon. Opened for business soon after. She has a fine head for figures. Bit stingy with the credit, if I dare say so. It's odd she closed so sudden-like. I'd wager there's more to this tale than we can say.
Many's the person comes to drink here, all bearing different tales. Now what's this doing here? I'll heal your wounds. There, tower in the distance. What says the map, Amazon? I'd not thought to find such a place here.
So I'm discovered at last. I've done nothing wrong. They say I dealt in banned goods. If it's true, I swear it was not my intent. I had no idea. But as I don't expect them to take me at my word, I was forced into hiding. I fled in such haste, all my goods were left behind. More's the pity, I suppose. Wish I'd thought to secure my dagger. It's a kind of charm what brings good fortune, you see. It's been with me since my first days peddling turnips. Without it, I feel not myself. But a fool to leave it in my own shop. Most like I'll never see the old thing again. But then, I've greater concerns at the moment. I've never seen trouble the likes of this. Even now, I feel the tears welling. It took all of my will and every last bit of gold to see that shop opened. And now, if you hadn't found me, I don't know what I'd do. Huh? No! Soldiers!
Aye, Arisen. Well met. We pursue a female merchant named Madeline. She is charged by His Grace with trafficking in those queer medallions. As a symbol of salvation, the sale of such is blasphemy and treason both. We mean to arrest her and uncover the girl's connection to the Zealot's leadership. We believe she is in hiding near here. Have you seen aught that might aid us? No. We have reports she fled here.
Ho! There she is!
Don't let her escape! Forgive me, sir. Duty calls.
You saved me. Thank you. As a reason, I suspect lying does not come easy. I'm sorry to have asked it of you. I can tarry no longer. I must seek safety somewhere further off. I'm at peace with the laws of my shop and merchandise. Such things can be replaced. But parting from you is a blow far more cruel. What? I speak from the heart. It shames me to ask for more, when you have given me so much. Yet, might you spare some gold for my travels? My hasty departure left me without a single coin to my name. If all goes well, I shall pay you back in full. Most likely. Eventually. Thank you. You show such kindness to this foolish girl, and I love you. Once I'm safely away, I will establish a new shop in whatever place my travels take me. And when my purse jingles once again, I shall track you down and repay my debt. Truth. Well, I must be off. I must say, before leaving Cassidus with you, my life was utterly hopeless. But see how far I've come. I even had a shop of my own, if only for a moment. I can take pride in that. And as this adventure failed to kill me, perhaps I may even learn aught from it. Or not. I know not what fortune holds for you, Arisen, but I trust it will be terrifically exciting. Please don't die. Promise me you'll come see me in my next shop. Farewell, Arisen.
Seems that many people live here as well. Those without have a trade or the means to earn a wage, live here. What meaning do you suppose those stones have? Someone in the castle must be the Knight's champion. Who?
Hail, Arisen. Good news.
His Grace has taken notice of your feats, selected you to lead an expedition. It is a difficult task, but of critical importance to the defense of the front. The Duke was adamant that none would do so fine as you, sir. The journey will take you afar, Arisen. If you've tasks to complete or personal matters to attend to, pray, do so now. It is like you will not see Grand Sorin for some time. Then come. The Duke wished to see you before you set out.
Pray, hasten to His Grace's side. We mustn't keep him waiting.
It seems the office of Arisen brings with it equal parts strength and ambition.
I am greatly pleased by your work, sir. I would see you rewarded for all you've done. Come, follow me. I have aught to give you afore you set out.
Thank you.
Strange. The ring ought hold sway over the lock that binds this chest. No matter. I shall see its contents are delivered to you later. Perhaps time has dulled the ring's magic.
Urgent news, Your Grace. A messenger has come bearing word from the Great Wall. The hold has fallen to a man calling himself the Leader of Salvation. He's taking captives and threatens to offer up a grand sacrifice to see the land cleansed.
The expedition will keep, Arisen. Head for the Great Wall at once and quash Salvation's designs before they're realized. This matter takes precedence over all others. Now go.
Well met, sir. Well met, sir.
Rumor has it Salvation works with a man known as the Knight's Champion. Here we can rest and manage it before we escape. Talk is, a band of woman thieves makes their den in these parts. It would be wise not to arouse the ire of the local bandits. Given the look of things, we'd best be well prepared before pressing on. heal your wounds. Cautious.
camp. Out here? Splendid woodland, and so rich in resources.
There, Master! Snow harpies!
Neutralize the poison. A great war. It was built to keep all manner of beasts from Grancis. It's a grander structure than the other holds we've seen.
R-
remember the item I asked you to find? Well, no. Pray, call again.
My spells are sealed.
numbers, Arisen. Restore your health. Hold on.
I owe you my life, sir. There are still others here.
Long last, aid arrives. 'Twas quite a wait, sir. The leader of those zealots made for the floor above. There's a passage here will take you there more quickly. I'll open it.
Brace for magic, Arisen. They attack in quick succession. The men of the wall could open it. It'll be easier going searching this area now.
Mad! Salvation is mad to conjure up such monsters! They'll be eaten, sure as the rest of us. Forgive me, sir, but I'll not open this door. I'll not be food for those beasts.
Sir, you are amazing! I thought the Arisen little more than the stuff of old tales. How wrong I was. Huh? The door? The door? Oh, of course, sir. I shall open it straight away. above, sir. Engaged in some dark ritual from the look of it. It makes my skin crawl just to think on it. Who can say what they aim to do? I'll open the rear door for you. Go. And make her be your shield.
Strength in numbers, Arisen.
Welcome. It would seem our fates are closely bound. The honeyed sleep of destruction will find this place, and all the world in its turn. Indeed, the coming night ill needs us, its faithful harbingers. Just as you and your hubris cannot hope to stop the divine beast that marked you. Before its might, you stand as useless and frail as this ungainly contrivance of brick and mortar. Nonetheless, the trice you might delay the dragon's coming is blasphemy just the same. Reduced to dust, but first they shall peel the flesh from your bones, my dear Arisen. Extent of your skill, dear Arisen. I see it was folly to worry of walls and armies while you still live.
However,
it seems my regret will be short-lived. Don't you feel it? The very air dances around us. The long night is come.
The dragon's reign at last begins! Merciful Wigan! Death! All-powerful and merciless Grigori! Behold, you unrepentant blasphemers! This is absolute truth! This is salvation!
The rantings of an upjump zealot make for tedious listening. His ilk serves no role in what is to come. Only my death will staunch the flood of destruction. A task still far beyond your means. If you would face me, seek me out, and I shall allow it. But heed the zealot's lesson well. When the weak court death may find it. Until then, I shall hold your little keepsake safe. Your dragon forged will speak for my diligence in that. The choice falls not to me, nor to the whims of fate. It is yours alone.
What meaning do you suppose those stones hold? What's that?
This all understood.